refer to the given typepad shown. So the question for number one, if W is 60 kilonewtons, compute the actual load on each member or in each leg. Okay? And in number two, if the allowable compressive load in each leg is 50 kilonewtons, what is the maximum value of W? So binaliktad, okay? May allowable compressive load yung in each leg and W yung hahanapin. Okay? So let's solve muna. Tsaka na muna yung number 3. Okay? So first, what is the analysis dito? So ganito yan. We can analyze this the same sa thrust. Okay? We can analyze this as a thrust member because this is obvious na yung legs natin is a two force member, okay? That is pin supported on its joint, and there are no moments here, of course, because that is pin. Okay? Now, if that is thrust member, we can analyze this by method of joints, where dito sa point A nag-limit yung mga forces or the point of concurrency. Okay, so assuming this is all intention, okay, as assumption lang yan, that is away from the point. Yan. So this we are analyzing this by joint method of joints, like the thrust na method of joints analyzing at point A. Okay. Now in thrust, we are we know that in method of joints we can use summation of forces vertical and horizontal. Okay. Now here this is obvious in three-dimensional, so we can use three equations dito: summation of forces along x, along y, and along z. Okay. But we will not do the manual calculation. We will use a calculator technique. Okay. So, mamaya ipakita natin. So, the first step here is to locate the coordinates of each joint. Okay? Because after that, we will compute or we will know the vectors of each member. Okay? So, first, let's solve the coordinates of A. So, the x coordinate of A must be 0 lang. Okay? The y coordinates of A, that is 1.35. And the z coordinate of A is 0 rin. Kaya naging ganito. How about in B? Ayan. The x coordinate of B, that is 1.5. Then the y is, of course, that is 0. Wala siyang offset sa y. And z is 0 also. Andyan siya sa x-axis talaga. Okay? How about point C or the node at C? So the x coordinate, that is -0.6, okay, because that is to the left from here, -0.6 along the x-axis, and the y coordinate is 0. Okay, is it correct? Correct, that is 0, and the z coordinate, that is from here towards dito. Okay, that is positive 1.35. Okay, how about at node D? So the coordinates is -0.6 pa rin kasi papuntang kaliwa. Then the y coordinate is 0. The z coordinate is doon sa likod, that is 1.35. Okay, now we can solve the vectors na. So unahin natin yung AB. The vector of AB. So that is just B coordinates of B minus the coordinate of A. Okay? So, bakit ganyan yung ginawa natin? The bakit B minus A is because, ayan nga, this is the head, this is the tail. So, in order to assume na that is intention, dapat B minus A tayo. Okay? So, by subtracting the coordinates, so, tingnan nyo, B, 1.5 minus 0, that is 1.5i. Okay? 0 minus 1.35, that is negative 1.35, and so on. Okay? So, that I, j, k is indicator lang yan sa, paano? Sa direction. No need to worry about that. Okay? How about the vector of AC? Teka muna. Before that, we will solve the unit vector na lang. Okay? Because this unit vector, ito yung nag-represent sa components, x, y, and z components ng ating internal force in each member. So, ito yun. So, by using our calculator, no? So, input muna natin, ha? So, that is in vector. Tingnan. Vector A. So, we will input the vector AB or the unit vector AB at vector A. Yung 1. Okay. Dapat tatlo yan. So, na ito, 1.5 and minus 1.35 and 0. Yun. After that, press CA. So, baliktan na ito sa 991 AC ata ito. Okay. So, to solve the unit vector, ganito lang. Ups. So, na-input natin ito sa vector A. So, 3 divided by the absolute of ups pa rin and vector A. After that, ito na yung magiging unit vector natin. Okay? Again, it represents the coordinates, I mean the components of the force along X, Y, and Z. Okay? So, ito. Nilagay ko na lang dito. Okay? I hope na nasundan ito. Okay, how about the vector AC naman? Okay? So, from here, dapat head minus tail. So, ito yung magiging head minus tail, yung concurrency. Yan. C minus A. So, sundan nyo na lang, ha? Ito yung mangyayari. So, C minus A. So, ito yung magiging vector niya. Next, again, we will compute the unit vector. So, A6CA tayo. Tapos, gawa tayo ng data. Dito lang sa apps, the button. Gawa tayo ng data, 2. And then, since nailagay na natin dito sa A, mag-vector B naman tayo. Dito tayo sa 2. Again, 3. Then, input this vector AC. So, negative 0.6. Negative 1.35 and positive 1.35. Yan. Okay. Then press CA. Then to get the unit vector again, apps. Then nasa vector B yun, yung vector AC. Divided by its absolute vector. Okay. Yan. From here, so got these values. Yan. So, andito yun na. Nakuha natin dyan. So, sinulat nyo naman dito. How about the vector AD naman? Ito. So, dapat D minus A. So, head minus tail. Okay? So, sundan nyo na lang. Dito yun. D minus A. So, after that, the unit vector naman. Ito yung importante kasi yung unit vector. So, input natin yan sa gawa tayo ng data, then i-input natin sa vector C. Okay? And what? So, that is negative 0.6, negative 1.35, and negative 1.35. Okay? After that, CA, and ups, then vector C, that is in 5 button, divided by the absolute of vector C. Yan. So ito yung ihala. Nadobe. So, ito yung unit vector natin. Okay? So, actually, the same lang dito. But ito lang yung iba. Magne-negative ito. Tingnan nyo. Yan. Magne-negative sa ikatlo. Okay? So, after that, we have all the vectors na. Yan. So, ito lang yung importante, yung unit vectors mo. Okay, kasi that is representing the x, y, z component of the force. Okay? So, ito. Unahin mo yung question number 1. If W daw is 60 kilonewtons, compute the axial load kilonewton on each member. Okay, so anong gagawin natin? Yan. For the force members, ilalagay natin yan sa 3x3 matrix. This is the force members corresponding each components. Okay? So, ayan. So, ano yung ilalagay mo dyan?
Yan.
Isulat mo lang yung lahat yan sa 3x3 matrix. So, first ito, nasa dito sa itaas. Then, the second row, ito. And then, the third row. So, papakita ko sa inyo yung calculator. So, CA na tayo. No need na yan. So, mag-matrix naman tayo dito sa mode 7. And, ilagay natin yan sa matrix A. And hanapin yung 3x3 that is here. 3x3. Okay. Then, input lahat dito. Or ito yung itong nagawa natin unit vectors. So, first, that is 0.7433 and minus 0.6689 and 0 and minus 0.2998 minus 0.6746 and positive 0.6746 and minus 0.2998 and minus 0.6746 and minus the same pala 6746. Yeah, so ito yung nasa matrix A natin. Then AC. After that, na-input natin yan. So, for the external loads naman, ito is yung the force over on each member natin. Okay? So, for the external load, ito yung W. Ilagay natin yan sa 3x1 matrix. So, ito yung mangyayari dyan. So, okay? So, ito, representing the load, the external load along X. Ito, the load along Y and the load along Z. So, from here, we don't have load along X, okay? So, zero yan. And load along Y, that is itong W. Going downward, kaya negative yan. So, ilagay na lang natin na unit load yan, 1. Okay? So, actually, pwede natin ilagay yung automatic yung W dyan, 60. But, and the next problem kasi, need natin i-recycle yung datas natin. Kaya, i-unit load na lang natin yan. Okay? Now, the Z naman, walang Z load dyan, kaya 0 rin yan. So, input natin sa calculator. Ito. So, from apps, gawa ka ng data sa matrix. And ilagay natin yan sa matrix B. So, hanapin mo yung 3x1 matrix. So, andito yun, number 4. Yan. Okay, input ng lahat. 0 and minus 1 and 0. Again, pwede natin i-diretso yung load na 60 dito ha. Automatic yung answer. Pero makikita nyo ito, what is the purpose? Bakit ginawa kung unit load yan? 1. Okay? Yan. So, press CA naman. Now, so, ayun. Inilabas lang natin yung W. Okay? Madidistribute yung W yan mamaya. Okay? Now, after that, ito yung i-input natin sa calcio. Okay? Ito yung mangyayari. And ito yung syntax na gagamitin natin sa calculator. Okay? So, follow na lang. So, this should be the negative of transpose. That is transpose of matrix. So, that is, balik ka sa apps. Then, hanapin mong TRN. Andyan sa number 2. Then, matrix A. So, take note yung members natin is naka-save sa matrix A. So, again, hanapin yung matrix A that is in 3. But that should be inverse. Okay? So, just click this button. Inverse, then close parenthesis. Then, hanapin mo yung matrix B. Ayun. Okay? So, ito lang yun. So, ang lalabas dito na answer is naka-form na ganito. Because we arrange this unit vector as AB, AC, and this should be AD. I'm sorry, correct na lang. This should be AD. Okay? So, ito, ganito yung arrangement na lalabas sa answer. So, ayun. Ayan. So, ito yung lalabas. So, what that does mean? Okay? Ayan yun, ha? So, ito yung lalabas. And that should be in terms of W. Kasi, ayun nga. In terms natin, in 1 unit load yun. So, anong ibig sabihin ito? Ito yun. 4.71. Sinulat yun lang dyan. Ayan ito. Okay? I hope, klaro lang. So, ito yung ibig sabihin niya. So the longer member AB is just ito, negative 4.271 of W S, and AC and AD also in terms of W. Yun. So bakit negative to? Because kaya nga nag-assume tayo ng tension dito. So pag nag-negative, the correct dyan is compression pala yan. That is towards the joint. Okay. So never mind na lang that. Indicator na yan if that is compression or tension. Okay. After that, if you will input the W dito, that is 60, automatic, masolve na natin yung lahat ng values dyan. Or pwede natin itong gawin. Ito, answer, times 60 na lang. Yun nga. Kasi kinuha lang natin yung W, pinactor out. So, pag nag-multiply tayo sa results natin by 60, ito yung lalabas na answers nila. Okay? Ito yung member A, B, AC, and AD. Okay? So, ginanito ko lang kasi mare-recycle natin ito sa second problem. It's up to you. You can automatically input the W dito sa yung in-input natin, diba? Sa loads. Okay? So, ayun. By substituting W here as 60, ito yung lalabas na answers nila. Negative for compression niya. Yun. So, let's proceed for number 2. If the allowed compressive load on each leg is 50 kilonewtons, what is the maximum value of W can carry? Okay, so kung ang kaya lang daw ng each member daw is 50 kilonewtons, ano yung pinakamalaking W na makakayang buhati ng tripod? So again, ito yun. Ito yung nakuha natin kanina in terms of W. So ganito lang. If AB is 50 kilonewtons, we will let AB as 50 kilonewtons. So ano yung value ng W mo dyan? So that is 117.07. So ganito lang yan. Okay, if we have 50, AB is 50. So i-cross multiply mo itong 0.4271. So divide na natin ng 0.4271. Ayan. So ito yung value ng W mo. Okay? Kaya nga ni-recycle natin ito para mas mabilis. Okay? How about if AB naman is 50 kilonewtons? Again, they have the same allowable load. Okay? 50 kilonewtons. So ano yung value ng W? So again, i-divide mo lang to sa by 0.5294. Okay, and we have the W as 94.5. And if AB is 50, of course that is the same. Okay, kasi nga by symmetry lang nakikita natin na ang i-carry nila na load is the same lang. And that should be 94.45 kilonewtons. So among the three, ano yung gagamitin mo na W? Ito bang 117.07? So, mali. Dapat yung mas maliit. Okay? Maximum yung sinabi dito, yung pinakamalaking kaya niya na hindi masisira yung system. Okay? Because if gagamitin natin itong 117.07, masisira na yung AC at yung AD. Kaya di yan pwede. Okay? While if itong 94.45 yung gagamitin natin, kayang-kaya ni AC and AD, and of course, kayang-kaya ni AB. Diba? Because ito nga, from 117.07, if yung basis natin is yung AB. Okay? So, this will govern. This load must be the answer. Number 2. Okay? Or this below. The answer below. They have the same numerical value naman. Okay? So, for number 3. If the load W is 60 kilonewtons at A is horizontal along the positive X-axis, compute the loads kilonewtons in each leg. So ito yung W ay papalitan ng load na along the x-axis positive, so going to the right, W, and that is 60 kilonewtons daw. Compute the loads in each leg. So the same pa rin yung ginawa natin sa number 1. Ito. So hindi pa na-erase yung data natin kanina. So ano yung mag-iiba sa data natin? So, dito, alam natin na hindi nagbabago yung direction ng forces ng each member natin. Ang nagbago lang dito is yung load. So, hanapin dito ups, then data. Palitan natin yung data natin sa matrix B. Yun. So, ano yung mangyayari dito? Pakita mo natin, ha? Yan. For the external load nyo yung nagbago. So, ito ba yan? Ilagay natin sa 3x1 matrix. So, x, y, and z representing the load direction. Okay. So, in the load direction x, ito yan, yung 6, yung w is andyan sa x along the x-axis, di ba? Kaya ilalagay natin yan dito. So, positive kasi going to the right. Going to the positive x-axis. How about the y? So, wala na siyang load sa y kasi nga transfer natin dito sa x. And of course, sa z, zero din dyan. So, yun yung papalitan natin sa calculator. Ayan nyo. So, dito gawin natin itong automatic na 60 kahit hindi na 1 unit load kasi hindi naman natin mara-recycle. Last problem naman to. Ito naman is 0 and 0. Yeah. So, after that, gawin natin ulit yung syntax na ginawa natin. Ito. Negative trans, matrix A and matrix B. And ito yung lalabas na answer. Okay? So, pakita ko na ulit. So, negative of ups. And hanapin yung TRN, nasa 2. Then, matrix A, nasa 3 yan, but inverse. Then, matrix of B. Yun. So, press equals. So, these are the answers. Okay? The same dito. Ilagay ko na lang. Yun. So, if you observe negative dito, you remember AB. And AC and AB is intention. Positive yan. Okay? Because makikita naman natin, ma-imagine nyo na, pag ang load is apply dito, ito is makukompress dito naman is matitense. Parang hihilahin niya papuntang doon kasi kaya dapat na reaction na dito is papuntang ganyan talaga. Matitension. Okay? From that, we solve the force in each members. Yun. So, that's it. So, i-practice nyo lang ng i-practice at mamamaster nyo to. This problem is very common in our board exam, the CE licensure exam. Okay? Baka babalik ito sa time nyo, at least man lang makatulong sa inyo to. Thank you and God bless everyone and enjoy learning.